Hello, everyone. My name is Alexandra Hughes, and I'm a member of the Interdisciplinary Women's Reproductive Health Collaborative at Purdue University, in collaboration with members of our Purdue University Pharmacy and College of Health and Human Sciences. Our team has worked the past few months to develop and implement a campus-wide campaign to increase the awareness and use of the two pharmacy vending machines, or PHVMs, located on the Purdue University campus. Multiple adverse health outcomes can be attributed to the failure to utilize contraceptives during sexual intercourse, and it has been estimated that nearly all people who are sexually active will develop a sexually transmitted infection at some point in their life. In 2018, Indiana reached an all-time high of STI prevalence. These adverse health outcomes can be widespread among college-age populations, as 50% of reported STI incidences occur from those ages 15 to 24 years. In addition to STIs, unplanned pregnancies can result from the failure to utilize contraceptives. In the United States, nearly half of pregnancies are estimated to be unintended. In Indiana, this contributed to around 7,000 terminated pregnancies reported in 2019, although we must recognize that not all terminated pregnancies would be attributed to being unplanned. The highest rate of terminated pregnancies was found between ages 20 to 24, with 31.3% of occurrence. Despite the high incidence of STIs and unplanned pregnancies, the use of barrier protection remains low, with only 24% of men and 34% of women reporting using condoms at last sexual intercourse. Based on these reports, understanding the determinants and reducing the barriers that influence contraceptive use is critical to improving public health. Previous studies have looked at the motivations and hindrances towards birth control use. Among college-age women, confidentiality is a barrier towards the purchasing of emergency contraception. In a study done with college students, researchers found the inaccessibility of contraceptives within a walkable distance from campus serves as a barrier if students lacked access to a vehicle. The setting of purchase also has considerable impact on the comfortability of purchasing contraceptives, with factors such as the characteristics of the store clerk, interactions with other customers, and the concerns of judgment or stigmatization the purchaser may feel can influence the level of embarrassment and furthermore influence the motivation to obtain and utilize contraceptives. Literature supports the deployment of discreet purchasing options to increase the utilization of contraceptives, consequently having an impact on incidences of STIs and unplanned pregnancies among college students. Condom vending machines utilized in Italy have demonstrated successful as a strategy to reduce purchase embarrassment, as well as reported an increased convenience for users to purchase contraceptives after pharmacies have closed. In January 2021, Purdue University implemented two pharmacy vending machines on campus located in buildings that students have 24/7 hour access to. The PHVMs contain multiple personal and sexual health products such as condoms, emergency contraception, and over-the-counter cold and flu medications at an affordable price. It remains unknown how to best disseminate information on the presence and features, for example, the available products, their quality, and their affordability of the PHVMs. Previous literature alongside our initial needs assessment has indicated that program messaging and content should highlight the PHVM products, locations, and payment options while promoting their privacy and safety. The primary objective of this project was to design, implement, and evaluate a community-based public health intervention for Purdue University's College of Health and Human Sciences, Department of Public Health, and the Purdue University Pharmacy as part of a Purdue University course requirement. The secondary objective was to expand the PHVM initiative through developing a campus-wide campaign aimed to increase awareness and use of the PHVMs. Additionally, the evaluation of this project aims to not only measure the awareness and utilization of the pharmacy vending machines, but to also measure the attitudes of the campus community towards them. Overall, this project aims to increase access to affordable and reliable personal and sexual healthcare products at Purdue University, with the hopes of bridging the gap between college-age students and having easily accessible and affordable personal and sexual healthcare products. The present data on these sites were collected as part of an initial needs assessment to gauge the present awareness of the pharmacy vending machines within the Purdue community, understand what features students want to know about, and also determine what communication outlets are most preferred for information dissemination. The needs assessment survey was distributed to 1,500 randomly selected students via email, as well as posted on social media, with a response number totaling 292 participants. The campus-wide campaign was guided by public health theories, including diffusion of innovations theory, the trans-theoretical model of change, and the RIA model. Dissemination materials were developed for physical and digital messaging with flyer distribution and social media and email blasts. Evaluation efforts will be done the same as the needs assessment via a web-based survey and will be completed in April 2021. As mentioned, the needs assessment survey resulted in 292 participants, 72.1% of which were undergraduates, with 9.2% graduate and professional students. The largest group of undergraduate respondents was freshmen, totaling at 35.2%, followed by sophomores, juniors, and seniors. The majority of respondents identified as female, and over half of respondents disclosed that they were sexually active. Additionally, most respondents indicated that they lived in on-campus housing. Around 50% of participants identified that they would be somewhat or extremely likely to utilize the PHVMs at both of their locations on campus, but over 95% had not yet done so. This could be attributed to lack of awareness regarding the presence of the machines, as over 60% of respondents were unaware of them and their locations on campus. Of the respondents who had purchased items from the PHVMs, contraceptives were the most prevalent products purchased, followed by over-the-counter medications. The survey participants indicated that the two most preferred forms of communication were the Purdue University emails and college department emails. Other preferred forms of messaging included social media and digital flyers, of which could be sent through group messaging for residence halls or other outlets of messaging within the university, such as social media pages. Additionally, participants indicated they utilized QR codes. For focus on the features of the machines, the information that indicated need was on available products, prices, location, and available payment methods. Furthermore, fewer respondents felt that contact-free purchasing, product source, quality, brands, and privacy to be important. This slide provides examples of our campaign posters, which were adapted to be both digitally and physically distributed to the Purdue campus community. We aim to have a cohesive look with Purdue branding, while also have them stand out to students. We focused on developing messaging related to prices, payment options, location, and product availability. We also wanted to give viewers an example of why the pharmacy vending machines are beneficial to them. This slide here demonstrates more colorful options for branding while appealing directly to students within the messaging and importance of use. Additionally, in partnership with the Purdue University Pharmacy, we developed a frequently asked questions page that this QR code leads to. It provides information on the Purdue University Pharmacy and lists the locations, products within the machines. Intervention, implementation, and evaluation are ongoing and expected to be completed in April 2021. The expected results will indicate an increased awareness and use of pharmacy vending machines, as well as positive attitudes towards the expansion of the program. The results of the campaign will be used to guide decision-making for Purdue University on potential implementation of additional pharmacy vending machines on campus and provide feedback on their features. Outcomes will indicate intervention success and shortcomings and may offer practical recommendations to guide community-based program development relating to the pharmacy vending machines. Specifically, findings will offer guidance for future pharmacy vending machine messaging on campus and program expansion. Findings and literature inform campus campaign strategies aimed at increasing awareness of affordable and accessible personal and sexual health care products. Additionally, these findings may assist public health practitioners with identifying appropriate community-based approaches supporting the reduction of barriers to sexual health care products and increase attitudes towards their purchase and continued use. Results will also reflect consumer needs of diverse product offerings, privacy, and purchase comfortability. Lastly, I would like to acknowledge those who have contributed to the development and promotion of this project and the continued effort of this initiative. If there are any inquiries, questions, or comments, they can be sent to phvmpurdue@gmail.com.